We are Catholic Extension, and we have a story to tell. For the next half hour, and throughout this series, we'll share inspiring stories. Stories of people who are making a difference in our church throughout the United States. For over 100 years, Catholic Extension has worked to make visible the power of faith in America's most marginalized communities by building faith, inspiring hope, and igniting change. Good shepherds, as Jesus teaches in John's Gospel, lay down their lives for their flock. They accompany the people of God, teaching and leading them to a better, more meaningful life, a life filled with faith. In poor, rural, and remote Catholic communities, pastors make great sacrifices to minister to their people. But if you ask them, they have no doubt that it's all worth it. They are making a great difference in the lives of their people, who really need the loving service of a good shepherd.
The Indian people here call God the Creator. From the Creator comes Jesus, comes the Spirit, and we're all one. One flock, one shepherd.
A priest has to be for those he serves. He has to be able to sacrifice his life for the sake of others so that they may have life in Christ. If you want a challenge, then serve in a missionary area. The missionaries are like the Marines of the church, you know, you're the first boots on the ground.
Job description of a priest is how many hours are you willing to put behind a windshield a day or a week?
I'm driving almost 1,000 miles a week. There's a very strong Catholic population in certain pockets. It's very much a ministry of trying to get to know people one-on-one, get to know them individually so that you can apply the gospel to their lives in a very particular way.
Good shepherd is to be available, but also be present even when you might not even be asked to be at a special spot.
If any young man is considering priesthood, ask God, is missionary life the life for me? And if you have a desire and an attraction to that, you know, that's a pretty good indicator that God is working in you. One moment where I felt as though I was making a difference here was after a funeral, and one of the elders came up to me and said, "Father, thank you for making it all about God."
You can't live without faith. Just by living life with the people in a faithful way and being present and being hopeful. So there's a special connection. It's home. I started coming out here during my college years when you're just full of adventure. And I was invited by a Catholic family movement. And as I entered the seminary in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, I decided, yeah, I'd just soon be a priest out in Montana with the desire to work among Native Americans. Our presence here as Roman Catholic Church has meant a lot to the people.
I'm a Dominican sister from Sparkhill and working on the reservation here now for 33 years. We need to be with them right here and now. And Jesus means a great deal to the people here. So Father Pete is a representative of that Jesus. And he definitely represents that Jesus to the people.
We're going to turn onto the road here to Rocky Boy.
Welcome to Rocky Boy. Father Pete's been here for umpteen years. He's a member of the tribe.
One of the elders, a few years before he died, he did the ceremony and he gave me his Indian name, which is Buffalo Walker. And that was a great honor.
We come to Mass and pray with him.
Well, I'm seen as an honorary member of the tribe, which doesn't happen here at Rocky Boy at all. I mean, I'm the first one. You enter into the hopes and the sadness or the suffering and the joys There's a fine line out here between hope and despair. You got to be able to join in both sides. There's a good community spirit. Employment out here is probably 70% unemployed. One of the challenges now, like many places, are the drug addictions, methamphetamines, and all the stuff that comes on. We just buried a 32-year-old boy last week. They might be praying over all the sadness or the addiction problems here. Just by the fact that you're praying, it means you're hopeful. It's part of the life. It's part of the, if you want to put it in church terms, Paschal mystery of living, suffering, dying, and rising. Happens every day, happens every year in people's lives, and to try to say this isn't the end. There is a beginning, there is life. Easter Sunday morning, we have the candle out there and people spend 20 minutes or a half hour coming up in procession, tying their prayer, their ribbon around the Easter candle. What would you like new life for at Easter? And so these are all the prayer intentions of the people this Easter.
Yeah.
Good to see you. And one of our people, Vernon the boy, made this baptismal fountain here, the three feathers there out of some quaking aspen.
And we'd sit and talk about God once in a while. He preaches with actions.
And some of the things that he does in the Catholic way is similar to some of the traditions that we do here too. I think Father Pete is considered one of those elders, you know, that helps out in prayer and religion.
He always finds time to be with us if we have any problems. Always available. Means a lot to us.
Means a lot to the community when he comes in and takes part and is very active with us in our beliefs. You know, he comes to not only our aid in the church, you know, but outside of the church. He is a good shepherd.
Couldn't have done what we've done out at Rocky Boy without the help of Extension all these years. Extension Society helped build this church with a certain amount of money. I mean, the people built it physically, but as far as Sister Margaret, Sister Kathleen, myself, I mean, the people here, they'll give when they can, but it doesn't keep everything going. So you'd live and pray with the people, and that's entering into the lifeblood of the people. It helps us all.
They understand who Jesus is through him, and I think that helps in their spirituality. He's a good shepherd. He's really a good shepherd.
Catholic Extension supports many good priests, priests who serve the people of God with a missionary spirit and with the heart of a shepherd. Pastors who are good shepherds build community by bringing people together. Like Jesus, the good shepherd, they don't give up on anyone, but go looking for the lost sheep until they find them. They are bridge builders, and they gather their flock around the celebration of the Eucharist. In today's increasingly diverse communities, they bring different cultures together around the same altar and in the same parish hall.
Churches in the South are very precious. The church in the South is alive. They know there's something special about this place. It's really a dream come true.
This community came to be a testimony of unity in the diversity, respecting the dignity of the other, and that's what is special about this community.
There were three mission churches, a small church in Adel, Georgia. There was a church in Nashville, St. Mary's, and a church in Lakeland, Queen of Peace, all served by the same pastor.
It was a mission territory. It's especially here in South Georgia, is only 3% are Catholics.
It's different because this truly is Bible Belt country, and our community is not wealthy. We're more than 50% Latino. We have Filipino members. We have a significant Afro-American community. Father Freddie's been able to put his arms around those folks.
Once we are here together, we are family. It's diverse, but when we come through that door, we're just one. One community, one Catholic community.
We all have our own talents, and that stuff he preaches about, the way he does it, you know, in a bilingual homily where everybody comes together through two different languages, it's pretty amazing.
I was building the church. Lo más fácil ya terminamos que fue construir.
Everybody enjoys everybody, you know. You get to know different people, different culture.
The multicultural aspect, I think it shows us how we can expand our faith.
Be a priest is not just to bring sacraments and do the sacraments. It's central, but also it's to build community. It is the mission we have to unify, to be one with Christ, and as Christ is one with the Father.
The fact that these are all going to be combined into the one community says magnificent things about the church and magnificent things about Father Freddie. That someone like that is able to bring these people together, is able to kind of go out to solicit funds and get property and get land to do something that I think is a marvelous expression of church.
It was really the support and the interest of the Catholic Extension Society that made this a reality for us. It encouraged others to do what they were doing, helping us. And they started helping each other, and they started seeing the bigger picture and what they could have if they wanted it.
To consecrate this church to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ under the patronage of Saint Anthony of Padua.
I'm grateful with Catholic Extension for that because it moved the people to really, we can do it.
The community contributed over $700,000. That's not counting the help that we received from the Catholic Extension Society. That was extra. It's exactly what I think you want the Catholic Extension Society to do, and that is to foster a sense of owning, a sense of, you know, contributing and getting excited.
That's kind of a miracle in itself, that the church in South Georgia is able to accomplish this with the help of Extension, of course, and with the help of other people who make this possible. But it's happening because of the vibrancy of the faith of the people.
It's the fact that we're centered in the gospel and that he explains it in that fashion that brings these disparate communities together and allows us to move forward as one community of believers.
Being in a new church, one together, it's just going to fulfill dreams for him, I know, and all of us. And it's going to, I can just see us growing.
Very energetic.
Yes, he is. We enjoy it.
Yeah.
My wife, she really enjoys him. When he's preached on Sunday morning, y'all might have heard an amen in there.
You can just feel the love and the caring that he has and the commitment that Father Freddie has to the faith.
We're making a new church. We're bringing two communities together, and hopefully more people will come. And that's why I like being Catholic, because we're strong.
To become one flock, one shepherd, we need to be unified, especially when we struggle so much for economic resources, human resources, pastoral resources, all that. To become one is to make the gospel effective and to make the gospel alive.
Father Freddie was the leader. He was a perfect priest to be here at this moment.
And the light has the effect of the sky, the heaven that there would be in the worship space. And at the heavens, the tabernacle has angels. and also the altar. And that's the connection between heaven and earth. The carpet is blue, coming out of the aisle in blue, representing the Eucharist as a fountain of life, Jesus Christ as a fountain of life, and you will see like a river going out.
For this is my body, which will be given up for you.
This is an oasis for them. This is a place where they can talk to God and they can tell Him their joys and their sorrows, and they can sing their music at liturgy, and it touches their heart.
We use in the church, and you're going to see the symbol, is three fish around. It represents the Trinity being one, and has that symbol that to become one. One pastor, one flock.
They will follow him like a shepherd is followed by his sheep. And that's exactly the perfect analogy, because they will follow the one whose voice they know. They will follow the one who they feel safe with and that they feel secure with, and that who will lead them and protect them.
I, as a pastor with the community, we are going to put the nets there, and like the Lord said, be fishers of men, and try to bring as many as we can with our testimony of life, hospitality to the Lord, to the Catholic Church.
This is a beautiful church, there's no question about it. But what's inside this church is even more beautiful, and that's the people. This is the model of church that is the reality we're going to experience in our country over the next 50 years. It is a very joyous moment for this community.
The dream is coming true. It has been an awesome journey.
In South Georgia, with support from Catholic Extension, a good shepherd, Father Freddie Angel, has been bringing diverse groups of people together to build something greater, one people in one church. Pope Francis has said that pastors who are good shepherds should have the smell of the sheep, because they share their lives with their communities and are with them in good times and in bad. They are one with them. They know their people's aspirations and their needs, supporting them in their challenges and in their struggles.
It's important for a priest working in a diocese like Tucson to have a missionary spirit, willing to go into a remote area, willing to work in challenging circumstances. To bring his expertise, to bring his talent, to bring the special gifts God has given him, to work for the people. Ministry is challenging, and it's important that our priests realize that they're not in this alone. Reservation here, the Tohono-O'odham Reservation, is as big as the state of Connecticut, so it's a very large space. Catholic Extension has helped us support our priests in outlying areas. Without that support, I don't know how we could have a priest serving in those remote areas, which are perhaps the most needed places for priests to give people hope and a future and nurture their faith.
I
At least a third of our parishes can't afford to pay the stipend of their priest because they are communities where there's little work. Most people are on fixed incomes. So organizations like Catholic Extension are tremendously helpful to our mission diocese to provide the support so that there can be a priest there.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
It's unfortunate they don't always get a great sense of the liturgical seasons because you're not having a Sunday Mass all the time. I find a lot of my preaching is catechetical, a lot of explanation, and try to put the gospel and the readings in context, in the larger context of the season.
The priests bring to the community a lot. They make us unite in the times of our celebration, to gather and to learn to be one. Like they say, you gotta believe and dream, and God will answer your prayers. It may be slow, but you get your answers through the Holy Spirit.
Sure. 85% of the Oatam are Catholic. Tohono means desert, so they're a desert people. We have 40 chapels. Now there are two friar priests. I'm one of them. Most of the villages at this point, even now, only have Mass once a month. They want you to be present with them. Luckily, we have great lay leadership. The teachings of the church very much dovetail into what is their traditional culture, which is they call the Himadag, which English translation is closest is the culture. But it's really a way of life, the whole way of life and their values. Both are very much are in sync with the gospel. And so that's why it was really not very difficult for the Oatam to enter the church. The people have always been here, and they see their culture, and they see their life, and their stories. Their life is here, in the desert. Even in the midst of the many struggles and the realities that now immigration, the border issues, and drug trafficking, and we're ground zero.
In a mission diocese like ours, we don't have a lot of resources. We don't have a Catholic university. We don't have a Catholic seminary. We have a shortage of priests. And so many times a priest has to wear different hats and the ministry kind of stretches you. So your days don't go from 8 to 4. They go way longer. They go beyond your parish limits because of this shortage of priests, because of this shortage of resources. You go and you help out your brother priest in doing the mission in these different realities, immigration, border diocese, and that in a sense keeps you very alive and very aware of what it means to be church. I truly do believe that faith can transform society because faith gets you closer to what's real.
As a Catholic Church, of course, the Eucharist is central to us. And my hope and prayer is that we will have sufficient priests to be able to minister in all of our communities, because no matter how small a community may be, no matter how remote a community may be, they need to know that God is with them, that God is there for them, and that the Eucharist is one way that that message can be strongly delivered. Well, Catholic Extension has been an incredible help to this diocese. I don't know where our diocese would be without the support of Extension. The faith of our native peoples is very deep. We're all united. And one of the most beautiful experiences I've had on the reservation is a prayer where there's an elderly person, there's a very young person, there's sort of a middle-aged person, and they're carrying ropes. And they dance around in such a way that they intertwine these ropes, all the while singing, "Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with ropes that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together." And it's that sense of unity, of belonging, that is so powerful. It's something I think we can all learn from. We're one family, because in the church, you know, there is really only one family in Christ.
For this is my body, which will be given up for you. This is my body, which will be given up for you.
The San Solano Missions are among the most economically disadvantaged parishes in the Diocese of Tucson. Catholic Extension supports these ministries so that everyone has the chance to experience the joy of the gospel and to partake in the Eucharist. The church is alive and growing at its margins, and it needs good shepherd priests, faith leaders to spread the joy of the gospel. Catholic Extension supports good shepherds and their ministries, building churches and faith communities across the United States, where resources are scarce, but the church is thriving. I hope you have been inspired by the people and the places we've shown you today. I pray that these stories will move you to follow the call of our faith, to reach out to those in need, and to evangelize by sharing the joy of Christ's love. What an exciting time it is to be Catholic in our country. Please visit our website, catholicextension.org, to join Catholic Extension in our mission of building faith, inspiring hope, and igniting change in mission dioceses across the United States. I look forward to the next time we meet here on Catholic Extension. May God bless you and all whom you love. Thank you.